Like that.
Oh my goodness sakes.
Now it's recording us talking.
Yeah? I'll be darned. Isn't that something? That's interesting.
Yeah.
See the old dry lake bed out there.
I wondered what that was.
Yeah,
so.
It's the old dry lake bed. One time, a lot of people don't know, but back in about 400 million years ago, there was about 4,000 feet of water here. We took the boys on last night to shoot the pistol.
Oh, so tell me about it. What kind of gun did you shoot?
A 38 special.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, man, them boys, they loved it, man. They shot up all my ammunition. And then they went, after I dumped the empties out, they picked them up. They're going to take them back to England with them for souvenirs.
That's awesome.
I'll show you. We get out here to Krell. I'll show you. And then this morning they had them fireworks.
Yeah.
And so they was going to go on the road to Vegas and set them off. I said, no, 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 no. Don't do it up there. Go out here to Krell where I showed you last night. So they came out here this morning and set the fireworks off. This is where they set them fireworks off this morning. I don't see no sign of it.
Did it look like they were over here?
Well, I thought I seen smoke, but I wasn't certain.
How much snow did you get up here?
Right here? Very little.
Okay.
Very up in the mountains, you'll see some. You know, they'll get a foot. But see, right here, you're only 4,800 foot. Up where I live, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,000 foot, 11,000 foot mountains, then we get 4 or 5 foot of snow.
Well, that's where you live, up there,
yeah.
Up high.
Yeah.
Well, there's more green up there, isn't there?
Well, you got more trees and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how far away do you live from here?
About 140 miles, 150 miles.
So what's that over there?
That's the old town of Tempiute.
Tempiute.
That's where some of the people live. Yeah, there used to be about 200 people worked up here.
And this was gold?
Gold, silver, lead, zinc, tungsten. Yeah, they got a big mill, everything up here. You'll pick a piece of rock up and it'll have 4 or 5 different minerals. You'll see when we get up there. Hopefully, some of the price of these minerals will go up. And if the prices go up, they'll open this up as an open pit mine. And that'll be a couple of 2 or 3, maybe 400 men working up here again.
What do you think it's going to take for the price of mineral to go up?
Yeah, we're spending our money. We're spending our money in foreign countries.
Yeah.
And we gotta quit that. We gotta buy America. Make America and buy America. And the dang disease the American people got is called cheap, cheap, cheap. If they can buy it cheap, they buy it. Well, our living costs are considerable more than the Koreans' living costs. And so they can make it a hell of a lot cheaper than we can. So what do? We buy it. And that's wrong. This mountain up here is where the survey monuments were that the airplanes hit when they were trying to dodge the radar. Yeah. That's all mineral-bearing rock. Yep.
It's amazing.
Yep. And down underneath us, 500, 600, 800 feet below us, there's tunnels and stuff where they've tunneled down and dug back into the high-grade veins of it.
Can people still get down in them, or is it all collapsed?
Oh, yeah. No, you can go in them. See, there's the mill buildings and shops and stuff there.
Can you get into the buildings?
Every once in a while through here you can see the old water line where the water line pumped that water all the way from down the bottom of that canyon up there.
Huh.
They got asbestos tile pipe.
Uh-huh. And what's that up there? Is that all?
That's a mill building. We'll go up
really came up in grade, didn't we?
Oh, hell yeah.
Elevation.
See, it's 6,000 feet already. We've come up 2,000 feet.
Wow. Well, that'd have been a heck of a bike ride, wouldn't it?
You wouldn't make it in the 20 minutes we've been.
No, I think more like 4 hours. Wow. Just the colors, though, they're just incredibly amazing. They're beautiful.
Yeah. See them here?
Yeah.
Isn't that pretty?
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
That old truck.
This is a shop. This is the mill.
So when they're hauling stuff out of here, they're hauling it out and they know that it's already separated.
Oh yeah, it's all and concentrates are hauling out of here. Yeah. See those little pipelines here? Conveyor belt, they dropped it down and they come out on a conveyor belt here from the crusher. This is all the crushing plant and everything up here. This is the crusher's all set in here.
Yeah, I see that. They had the screen set up and all that.
And there's the tipple where they dump the ore in the tipple. The big crushing plants are set up there.
Is that the entrance to the mine?
No, right, that's there? A crusher pit.
Oh.
That's the mine way up here on the hill.
I got you. Wow. This is crazy.
We're coming up. We're going to go up to the office building where the offices were. Places like that, cafeteria, and all that stuff. Bunk houses and stuff.
Yeah.
Offices, each one office, yeah. Switch house.
Wow. Just keep going up, huh? There's some rail. This is the crusher pit.
Yeah, that's where they dumped the trucks, yeah. This is high-grade ore that they didn't use. They just dumped it there. The railroad tracks out of the mine.
Yeah.
pressure cones. There's one of the mine entrances right there.
Yeah. Where's it? Is more just on around the mountain?
Up
higher?
Up, yeah. There you be. That's the mine tunnel. That's where the train track come out, see the tracks out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's that rope there, or that cable for?
That's signal. A signal line to let them know the train is coming out and stuff.
Huh.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. I don't even know what to say. This is pretty cool. Literally cool. I got my headlamp on. I know. I don't know. There's no way for you to really see. There's a pile. It's really cold. It's windy. There's a ton of wind coming through here. And look back. Wow. See, that's on the ceiling looking up. There, that's the ceiling. Over here's a pipe. Looks like a water line or something. Some kind of a cage. Yeah, the cage that keeps it from collapsing, I reckon. There's some piles of dirt. This is down here on the floor. Really interesting. But it is freezing cold. Wow. It's cold. There's the train tracks. I didn't bring a jacket. I didn't even think about it being cold in here. That's the ceiling now. There's nothing, no wood blocks above you. It's just rock. It's beautiful. It's amazing. It really is. Back to the entrance. I can't go in there and climb over that pile. That stuff just looks like it's rich in something.
It is. It's rich in iron. See all the rust?
Yeah.
That's ferrosulfide. FeSO2. FeSO2. It's good quality stuff. They just got no use for it.
I got you.
Because most of the stuff that come out of here was used for hardening steel. And they don't make steel in the U.S. anymore, to speak of.
Yeah.
So they don't need it. And they can get it, the Koreans and the Japs and the Chinese can get it out of Africa and different places cheaper than we could mine it and send it to them.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's a kind of a moot point. But if they start making steel in the U.S., then the price of tungsten will go up.
Really see that dry lake bed.
Oh yeah, wait till you get on top.
This is pretty cool.
See that peak right up there?
Yeah.
That's where we're going.
Right in that area.
Yeah. Trees, you figure each one of these trees you're looking at burns up anywhere from 500 to 700, 800 gallons of water a year. So you know why it got so much desert here.
Huh. Yeah, so if the trees were gone, I've been really thankful for the trees.
Well,
it provides for shade.
Wrong with trees, you know, there's nothing wrong with trees. I like trees.
Yeah.
But we don't need all this scrub juniper.
Yeah.
It's no good for nothing.
Yeah.
Well, it don't even make good, decent firewood.
Yeah, it's too soft, isn't it?
Well, it burns too fast.
Right.
It smells good.
Yeah, but it's sooty.
If you got a sugar mama and you want to sit there and cuddle up by the fire and that and smell a good old cedar fire, it's good for that. But for heat, it ain't worth a damn.
Yeah. You just got to go cut them down, right?
Well, no. If you take these prisons and give them a handsaw and have them go out here and saw them all down, saw them up, put them in a big pile, the good wood, take down and give to the old folks that need wood. Make them prisoners work for their bologna and their sausage gravy every day. Peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Old Joe Arpaio down there in Phoenix, Arizona, that's what he does with his prisoners. He puts them on a chain gang, gets them out there, and they clean the brush and the trees and the rocks, and he gives them time off. Boy, he is the most controversial rascal I've ever seen. Oh, I tell you, the ACLU's after him, and half the other government bigwigs are after him and stuff, you know. And he don't have it coming. And he just stands and sticks to his gun to say, Maricopa County and the people in Maricopa County like me. They voted me in now for 25 years, and I'm not going to change. And what he does is he's picking on those illegal aliens. And he picks them up. He don't fool with them. Boy, he picks them up and he ships them right out. And so the Latino and the Latino lovers, they don't like that, you know. And so they're them and the people that put up this illegal immigration, they're hammering the hell out of the poor old guy. And I don't think that's right. But he don't back down. And I believe that if more people would act that way in different places, it'd put a stop to it. You might not have to like what the other guy likes, but you have to respect his right to like it. That's what I fought and bled for.
Do you think that we're headed in the wrong direction as a country?
Oh, hell yes.
Yeah?
Oh, man, yes. Oh, gracious, yes. Yeah, we've got to turn this around. We've got to get rid of Obama and Hillary and all them people that are going for that massive liberal socialistic type of government. We just can't absorb it. There's not enough... there just isn't enough, you know. Our kids, if we never charged another thing, couldn't pay off our debt the way we're going. That's not fair to leave them that kind of crap.
Yeah.
The Democrats, since old Bill Clinton and them got in and Obama and all that, that's all they've been doing is raising our taxes and printing money by the bucket load. I mean, by the bucket load. And we just can't subsist. And the thing of it is, they espouse that, oh, we're doing this for the people. We're doing this for the people. Well, just sit and think about it. What people? What people are they doing it for? They're doing it for the ones that's too lazy to get off their ass and go out and do it themselves. And stand up there and jump up and down and say, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, Mr. Obama gonna build me a house. Mr. Obama gonna build me a house. You know.
Yeah.
And that's bullshit. Quit spending these socialized programs, you know. This Obamacare is just killing us.
Has it affected you in any way?
Well, hell yeah, it cost me $2,000 a year.
And why is that? Because I don't understand.
Because I have to have insurance.
Right. Rather than being able to just do without.
Pardon?
Rather than doing without.
No, I've got insurance. I've got a good insurance, but it ain't good enough. It only pays 80%.
Okay.
And so when I had my hip, it was a $240,000 bill. Well, they only paid $200,000. That left me to pay $40,000. Well, hell, I can't afford to pay $40,000.
Sure.
So I pay $2,000 a year for added insurance for 20% bill. And I don't think that's right. It used to be I only had to pay about, maybe $800 or $900. But since Obamacare kicked in, why, it's went up to, let's see, it's actually $2,380-some. Those far mountains out there is about 40 miles.
How far across there is it?
Well, let me see. That far, far mountains over there is just right at 100 miles. The next one, the closest one there, is probably about 25, maybe 35 miles across.
So the mountains that are way out there.
Way out there, those gray ones.
100 miles.
That's 100 miles away. Yep. I'll tell you what that is. That's Amethyst Peak over by Tybee, which is another mining town like this. Now, you wanted to get some rock for your kids?
Yeah.
Well, get out right here and walk around, and this is, you'll find all kinds of them.
Just hit you over the ledge. It's beautiful. All right, let's go find some minerals. Good choice. This is super cool.
Gold here.
Yeah, and what is that? What's food?
Iron pyrite.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's really not worth much, is it?
Mm-mm. Not worth nothing.
Somebody's been up here camping.
Oh, yeah.
Deer hunters, rock hounders.
So is this going to be the kind of place you come with your friends?
Yeah. Yeah, we were up here two Saturdays ago. We had 40 people up here.
How do you know you found good quality stuff? Like how do you pick out? What do you choose to grab? You look for the reflections in the sun. Here.
I'm nothing in this one.
Okay, so you just kind of look at them and try to find stuff.
Yeah.
And then what about like rocks like this? It's really not worth anything. Are you still trying?
You can't say that because there might be something in there. There's nothing. I'm trying to see if I... Hand me that piece right there. See it? Yeah. Okay, see that kind of a bluish stuff?
Uh-huh.
That's zinc. See the pyrites in there?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Hmm. Let's see. But you can find things like...
Got one right there.
Here.
Yeah.
But you can find things like jade and those kinds of things.
Not here.
Okay. Mm-mm.
Quartz, calcite, garnets, quartz crystals.
Oh, that's quartz crystals.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Huh. Now, do you typically, when you're looking at stuff, if there's a rock that has some mineral in it, you try to break it to see if there's more?
This whole face is high grade ore, lead, zinc, silver, some gold.
See, there's some strains in
things,
right?
Yeah, but not much. You're looking for blue and silver. There's zinc. See this here? That's zinc.
Okay, how do you know that?
Well, just...
The white?
Just know it.
Yeah, and this would be the quartz stuff?
Yeah, quartz. Now, this is where you find gold. It's so microscopic that you can't see it in here. See it in here? And if you assayed that... You'd probably get some microscopic gold out of there.
Mm-hmm.
Here's some more zinc, see it?
So that's got some value in here.
This rock. Yeah. Well, this whole thing is value. Now a clicker.
Blue and black.
That's galena.
But that's kind of in a quartz.
Mm-hmm. That's a piece I send to your kids.
Yeah, that's neat.
Mm-hmm. You have it. I don't want it. I got more of it.
Here, you tell me to I'll grab it. What about something like that?
Not a lot of pyrite crystals, yeah.
Uh-huh.
A little bit of zinc in there.
Not really much, is
uh-uh.
it? So, I heard you talking last night to those guys about polishing rocks.
Not left, right there.
Is that something you try to do? Is you find little gems and
mm-hmm,
polish
mm-hmm.
them up?
Yep. There's a little garnet.
Garnet?
Mm-hmm. That's a good specimen. Pretty big to
yeah, for sure.
carry on a bicycle, but.
Well, maybe I can just mail it or.
Huh. That's another big one.
Here, I'll get it. Is that there?
Yeah. Mm-mm. So you got blue in there?
Yeah.
Silver.
Huh.
I'll keep that one.
That's neat.
The whole vein of it there, see it?
Oh, of the silver, yeah. Yeah, right here.
Mm-hmm. The whole
All the
vein.
Way up.
Mm-hmm.
It's just kind of...
Yeah.
That is incredible.
Wow. That's what you got.
Yeah.
Look at that big piece of boulder right there. See the pyrite showing through it?
Yeah. Yeah, right there on the top corner.
Left. See it? Solid pyrites.
All through there. Wow.
Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
Look at this piece right here. Look at that solid piece of pyrite right there. See it?
Mm-hmm.
Is it showing up in your camera?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ain't worth nothing, but it looks nice.
Yeah. Pretty, isn't it?
Yeah. I was going to say, it ain't worth nothing, but it looks nice.
Hmm.
Now, I take you on those roads, but they're washed out so bad that... I don't want to take this pickup down there. I had a Jeep or an SUV or something, you know.
Yeah, shorter.
Yeah, I would, but
yeah,
the roads are just so bad. And this one's a good pick. There's a big shaft up there.
Yeah.
And they haul it up there and drop it down that shaft. It dropped down almost 3,000 feet.
And then haul it out.
Haul them, and then they'd haul it out on the train and put it through the crusher. Yeah.
I mean, it is just a maze of roads.
Yeah.
All for mining.
Yep.
And another mine shaft right there, or a tunnel.
A tunnel, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
That bush right there, that's Brigham tea or Mormon tea. And take that and dry it, and then steep it weak. Makes good tea, cleans out your kidneys. A lot of people use it for that. And you take it and make it stronger, and it'll be a kind of a laxative type. If you got a stomach ache or something like that,
mm-hmm.
That's what it. But I tell you what you need to do is go over and grab some of that.
Yeah.
And just take it, because it's not very heavy, and I don't know if I've got a baggie or anything to put it
yeah,
in.
Yeah, I've got a bag it back there. So you're talking about this stuff right here.
That right there, yep, just break it off, a couple of them.
You want the more tender ones, or it doesn't matter? And we just need to.
It only grows around a 6,000 foot elevation, give or take about 200 feet each way. Yep. Yeah, see, there's some more Brigham tea. See?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right there. Mm-hmm. My mom used to send us boys out, and we'd get that big sackfuls of it for her. And she'd dry it out, keep it. Every day she'd have a big old glass of Brigham tea. Yep. Take a couple of spears of it and kind of break it up, put it in your boiling hot water, let it steep for about 10 minutes. Yeah, good old glass of Brigham tea. But don't make it too strong, because it will give you have a laxative tendency.
So two or three spears.
Yeah,
well, those little green spears.
Yeah, well, not the whole one. Just take, say, trial and error. That's what you're going to have to do.
Okay.
Start with one. If that ain't enough, put another one in there.
I got you.
You'll learn, you know.
Yeah. What do you, you'd consider yourself pretty healthy for your age, wouldn't you?
I would hope to hell.
Yeah. What do you contribute to being healthy?
Eating a lot of dirt when I was a kid. I can't say it was clean living, I'll guarantee you that. Hard work. Not being babied. I raised on a ranch when I was 8 years old. I had to work. I left home when I was 13. I graduated from high school when I was 16. Joined the Marines when I was 17. And tough.
Mindset
had a lot to do with it. Just like now, hell, I'm 79 years old. You don't see me sitting around pandering, walking with a cane and stuff like that. I got an artificial knee, got an artificial hip, artificial back, artificial right shoulder. Yeah. Yeah, but don't let it slow me down.
But that's what it is. It takes mindset to overcome those things, doesn't
yeah.
it?
My theory has always been, I tell everybody that, the kids, my nieces and nephews, well, doesn't that hurt? Yeah. Damn right it hurts. But my theory is that pain is weakness leaving your body. And that's what I go by. And like I say, I rodeoed professionally until I was 58 years old.
Yeah, tell me about that.
I just rodeoed. you know, saddle bronc ride and steer wrestle wherever I could.
What motivates you to ride in a rodeo like that? I've always wondered.
Proving to myself that I was still man enough to do it. Still tough. Yeah. That's the only reason.
So you're probably competing against guys that are
in their 20s.
20.
Yeah. Exactly. But
what's living that life like? The rodeo life, the circuit life.
I didn't live the rodeo life per se. I would travel 300 or 400 or 500 miles Friday afternoon and evening to get to a rodeo at 7 o'clock at night, maybe 500 miles away. I'd jump in my plane. I had a own plane, own three planes. And I'd jump my plane and fly that far just to ride in the rodeo, and then get done, get up the next morning, jump in a plane and fly 600 miles to another town to ride in a different rodeo.
Wow.
And then Sunday, if it had an afternoon show, I'd go to that show and then fly home and get up Monday morning and go to work.
And when you say go to work, are you talking about on the ranch?
No, or? No. I was general superintendent in heavy construction.
Oh, okay.
I built dams and bridges all over the world. Now look at that view.
Wow.
There's three ranges of mountains. Four ranges of mountains you're looking at there. One, two, three, and four. There's Rachel down there in the bottom of the canyon, see it?
Yeah.
Thought we was mistreated as hell. We was kids, we didn't get candy, didn't have oranges, didn't have ice cream, and you know, all we had was good roast beef, taters and gravy, and good wholesome cow's milk, you know. Until we growed up, didn't realize how good we had it. That's what I told all the kids, and my granddaughter when she was a little girl, you know.
Yeah.
So, you gonna eat all that candy? Yeah, she says, you gonna be so sweet the ants will carry you away. that dike is man-made, and that's where they put all their waste and their sediments and stuff in there from the mill. Flumed it down there.
Yeah. So that down there, is that just mud? Is that what that is?
Well, it gets wet enough, it turns into alkali mud. It's alkali.
But it's just crusted soil?
Yeah.
It's not like rock or salt?
Oh, no. It's just heavy, heavy, heavy alkali salt. That's all it is. Nothing grows hardly.